who joined the club in midweek from St Mirren. The former captain of Scotland under 21 side lines up in midfield beside Scotland's newest full international, Phil O'Donnell, who made his debut against Switzerland on Wednesday. And Hearts have three teenagers in their squad of 13 this afternoon. 18-year-olds Gary Locke and Kevin Thomas are on the starting lineup, and 19-year-old Alan Johnston is on the bench. But the best news is the return of Alan McLaren to defence after injury. So, top of the table clash handled this afternoon by Eric Martindale from Newlands. And Hearts with a very impressive record in recent times against Motherwell, particularly at Tynecastle, it's fair to say. But Motherwell entering this match with substantial confidence, tempered, of course, by that setback last week at McDermott Park, when they were the victims of a 3-0 result against St Johnstone, although that did not reflect accurately the balance of play. It will be interesting to see how Paul Lambert settles into this Motherwell lineup. Tackled by McKinnon on Locke, giving the first free kick in the match to Hearts. A fine start to the season, McKinnon. The marker was Krivojevic, and Kevin Thomas couldn't control that. Collected now by Brian Martin. Lambert available again on the far side. There's Tosh McKinley. That's a good pass. And that's very well read by Chris McCart. Fine defending by the Motherwell captain. And this time Krivojevic is with Thomas. Good tackle. McGrillan stealing that from George Wright. The run was made from midfield by O'Donnell. Well, out of luck there, he tried to change direction to get away from Levine. Levine's in trouble. This is McGrillan. He's all in his own for the moment, supported well by Graham. A very enterprising attack that, inspired by McGrillan's industry, supported well by Ali Graham, a little enlarged in the Motherwell attack. McCart's header. Lambert. McCart. Krivojevic. Now McKinnon. Using Krivojevic as the decoy there. This is Shannon. And now Dolan. Good possession play by Motherwell. Advantage will apply. Mackay guilty of a foul on Dolan. Still Motherwell stringing passes together. Dolan collects the loose ball again. That's a good pass. Paul Lambert. Well, that would have made him a real hero had his first real attempt and goal gone in. Well, Lambert certainly appears to be enjoying this return to Premier Division football. So McKinnon now with the corner. Ali Graham on the near post. McMillan. Well, a very ambitious effort that. Great pass from Levine. Disappointment there for young Kevin Thomas, the under 21 international striker. Graham's header. This is Lambert. Trying a little too much on the ball with McKinley in close attendance. Here's Jamie Dolan. Good movement there from Graham and from Lambert. Tremendous effort there by Paul Lambert. It was superb football from Motherwell. And Lambert was picking his spot there with his left foot. Motherwell keeping on the pressure now. That really would have been one of the goals of the season. There's Shannon, stopped in his tracks by Henry Smith. But what magnificent play that was from Motherwell. And Paul Lambert really has settled very quickly indeed. Linking here. As the ball was played into the gap for Ali Graham, and knew what he was about there, playing that into the path of Paul Lambert. Look at this swerving ball beyond Henry Smith, who was helpless, and it comes off the bar. The header there by Dolan. Another will get the throw. Graham helps it on for McGrillan on the turn. Well, it's a very promising striking combination, that. Harry Graham and Paul McGrillan. So the long throw, giving Graham the chance for a little head flick on. It's very difficult to defend against that. And McGrillan making a very good turn, not quite the power in the shot that he wanted. John Robertson's header inside, there's Krivakovic. McKinley playing it forward. Here's Cahoon. He's away from Krivakovic. A great chance for Hearts! And very good goalkeeping there by Dykstra, who made a fine save from Cahoon. The first time the Motherwell defence has been seriously breached here. It was beyond Chris McCart, who couldn't get to that. Well held up by Cahoon, who deceived Krivakovic. But Dykstra got his heel to the ball there, spreading himself. Kinley's corner. Bit of bumping and boarding inside the area. Cahoon went down there. There's O'Donnell winning it for McGrillan. Off goes O'Donnell again. Such a powerful runner from midfield. Going away there from Gary McCart and from Gary Locke. Great play by O'Donnell. Wow, what a magnificent counter-attack that was. Created by Phil O'Donnell. He really is maturing into an outstanding midfield player. Incredible engine the young Motherwell player has. Using it to good effect. There's McKinnon. Well taken by Henry Smith. Good, confident goalkeeping. Kinley forward, Cahoon playing through the middle now, and a clash there with Krivakovic. Well, the Yugoslav defender was living dangerously there, leading into John Cahoon as the ball went skidding into the area. The referee had a perfect angle though to assess that. So here was Cahoon, and was he pushed by Krivakovic? Well, he may have had a claim. Dykstra can go for a run out of his area. Change the angle of the dropping ball now. Straight towards Graham. Here's Dolan. Neat footwork from Dolan. This is McKinnon. And turned away to the corner by Alan McLaren. Yet more good attacking play from Motherwell. Dolan doing extremely well there. Sidestepping the first tackle. Getting the ball before Gary Locke. Whipped in by McKinnon. There's Martin, and he too was very well policed by Neil Berry. That really was top-class defending by Berry. Martin in full flight going for that, matched every inch of the way. There's a major threat inside the area for Motherwell. Dolan trying to touch that on. Goal kick this time. Sandy Clark looking on. It's been a very interesting match all over, and Sandy Clark will appreciate that this is no easy task, overcoming Motherwell in such confident mood. Mackay forward. Cahoon again losing out to Krivakovic. What a match he's having for Motherwell. Cahoon recovering well. It's one for Thomas to chase. Thomas did well. He forced Shannon to turn that away for the corner. Motherwell fullback wanted to allow that to run for a goal kick. Thomas wouldn't let him. Powerfully built youngster. There's Tosh McKinley. Gary Locke offering himself short. Dykes is in trouble. Well, I think Alan McLaren was distracted there by Steve Dykstra on that very colourful top. Well, this is one Steve Dykstra will be happy to see coming to no harm. He was in real trouble there in no man's land. And no more time to add on by referee Martin Dale. It's been very entertaining in patches, with Motherwell holding a little bit of sway over the piece in the first half and coming closest to a goal when Paul Lambert linked superbly with Harry Graham and struck the crossbar with Henry Smith beaten. But at half-time, it's Motherwell 0, Hearts 0. Conditions have improved during the interval. Sun shining now as Muller will start the second half, looking to cash in some of the fine outfield play. He certainly threatened the Hearts' defence on a number of occasions in that first half without being able to make the breakthrough which their play merited. But Hearts were always dangerous on the counter-attack, and John Cahoon could easily have given them the lead. Here's Neil Berry with Ali Graham. McKinnon turning well. Missing out McGrillan though with a pass through the middle. McCart looking after Cahoon, deciding against the pass back. He tries to play that out for a throw. Well, John Robertson has frequently been a thorn in the Motherwell flesh in recent seasons. It's a quiet match so far, but that's probably the likely time for him to produce a goal. A feature of the striker's play so often. Out of things and then gets a chance. A few better at Robertson than taking them. There's Brian Martin. Such a good servant to Motherwell since his transfer for £175,000. Also from St Mirren, the same place as Paul Lambert. There's Martin again. Under pressure from Robertson, he did well. So Motherwell throw, turned away there by McLaren. Graham helps it on. Down goes McGrillan. A collision with Berry. No question of any foul though. Shannon's header. McGrillan backing into Berry, who stood up well to that. Here's McGrillan, but he likes the ball better. That's a very neat turn. Driving at the Hearts defence. That's for O'Donnell. It's a classic from Motherwell. Phil O'Donnell's first goal of the season, capping a week you'll never forget. Well, this goal was brilliant. Coming from midfield, McGrillan's tongue was superb, going away there from Berry. Now look at this run, driving at the defence. O'Donnell sprinting up from midfield in the middle, getting to that first. It's his weaker foot, the right, and he passes the ball into the net. The goal of great maturity from O'Donnell. And it's very hard to grudge Motherwell the lead at this stage. The goal coming 4 minutes into the second half. Levine breaking from the back. Hearts have to come forward now to save the match. There's McKinley. O'Donnell neatly forward for Lambert. Graham goes to the left, McGrillan's on the right. Dolan presents an option inside. Here's Graham. Dolan, the target again for the pass. Lambert wants it back. All of the ball players cut. They want the ball. None more so than O'Donnell. Good running again. Now Dolan. And just out of reach there for Lambert. A fine play again from Motherwell. And Paul Lambert almost opened his account for his new club there. The Hearts will make a substitution. The player being withdrawn is John Robertson. The Hearts supporters not entirely happy about that. And he comes off. Not been a happy afternoon for the Scotland striker, but the replacement is 19-year-old Alan Johnston. And here's Thomas breaking. He's very quick. Beautifully tackled there by Lambert. Kept his eye on the ball all the way. And that's too long for McGrillan. Tackle there by Shannon from the rear on Cahoon. Cahoon goes down, looking for treatment. The referee waves play on. Here's Ali Graham. That's for McGrillan, who's onside. He's got a touch to the ball. And it's swept away from under the crossbar by McLaren. Cool, effective defending by McLaren. And now there will be a hold-up while the referee has chance to give treatment to, a low treatment for Cahoon, but what a good effort that was by McGrillan. McLaren knew he was getting the ball in plenty of time. The left knee is a problem. It's a serious blow to Hartz. Not the kind of injury which might be cleared up quickly. We'll see how this happened again. The pass played here by George right forward for Cahoon. Shannon was coming in behind him very strongly. Leaned in there, got his foot to the ball. And then left knee buckled there going down. Shannon won the ball all right. There was no free kick. Little consolation though, I'm sure, to John Cahoon. That's Scott Leach who's replaced Cahoon. Away from Locke. The early ball played in for Graham. That's held on for McGrillan. Another excellent Motherwell attack. And Paul McGrillan, having scored 5 times this season so far, certainly has an eye for goal. And that move showed an excellent understanding. Fine play here by McKinnon, slipping Gary Locke and then whipping in the cross nice and early here. Graham knew exactly where McGrillan was, helped it onto his path. That's a good block by Smith. That's Furlamb up the chase. McLaren playing it forward. It's kept in by McKinley. That's straight to Steve Kirk. Here's Lambert again. Kirk once more. That's O'Donnell with a chance for the second. And a fine tackle by Gary Locke, denying the Scottish international the chance to tie the game up. Good young player, Locke. Bill O'Donnell explaining, I think, if we can lip read, that he didn't see Gary Locke. He thought he had much more time. I think that's obvious from this. He was measuring the shot, and then Locke arrived. This is Rob McKinnon. Right for the cross, struggling there. Henry Smith back in towards Kirk. A chance on now! And great goalkeeping by Henry Smith. He had to improvise, and he did so. It's kept Hartz in the game. Well, how did Hartz survive this? Henry Smith not happy, I'm sure, with that clearance. Here was McGrillan returning it quickly. Steve Cook did well to get away from Berry, but then Smith made a very good stop. Lambert's corner, the outswinger this time. Headed away well by McLaren. McKinnon trying to find Lambert with a quick return pass. Goal kick to Hartz. Shannon forward to McKinnon. That was Dolan. There's no offside there. All the Malone attackers onside. Berry with a pass back. It's difficult there for McKinnon. The chance is on there for McGrillan. Can he get there? And the match is surely now won for Motherwell by Paul McGrillan. Well, Motherwell have performed so well this afternoon. The pass back there from Berry was short. It put Henry Smith in trouble. McKinnon won it fair and square. And it was an easy task for McGrillan to get to the ball ahead of Alan McLaren. Sensible in the part of the Hearts management, preventing George Wright doing any more damage. O'Donnell makes space for himself. On the touchline is McKinnon. McGrillan laying it off for Jamie Dolan for the long range shot. Almost a thought, it was a splendid save by Henry Smith. The layoff there from McGrillan, Dolan supporting on his right foot. That would have gone in all right. Great save by Smith. So the throw taken by Martin, there's Phil O'Donnell. And the final whistle goes. It's been an outstanding performance by Motherwell, justifying their place at the top of the league. And the goal's coming, the first from Phil O'Donnell in 49 minutes.
a goal created by the excellent player Paul McGuillan, and it was a little striker himself who popped up to clinch the match 3 minutes from the end after excellent work by Rob McKinnon. A fine overall team performance, and Hearts battle hard to no avail. Motherwell the winners by 2-0.
Phil, your international debut in midweek and a goal this afternoon, a week to remember?
Yes, definitely. It was smashing getting on Wednesday, and then to come back down to play in the Premier League again and sneak a goal in the second half, get a good result with the team is smashing.
Paul, an under 21 debut in midweek and then a goal again today. What's the big difference for you this season?
I think this season we're playing a lot with a lot more confidence as well. We're playing from the back instead of just punting it forward, what we were doing last year when we were under a wee bit of pressure. Certainly, we're playing total football this season, I think, is the main ingredient for us doing so well at the start of the season.
What targets have you set yourself for the rest of the season?
I think to try and be as consistent as possible with Motherwell, get a good league position and hopefully try and get another international game. That's the targets I've set. I loved it when I went on Wednesday night and I would thoroughly like to play in it again.
Do you actually enjoy the knockers at the moment, suggesting that you're going to fall back down the league?
Well, there are always going to be knockers. We've seen they'll do this, they'll do that. But if we keep plugging away and keep staying there, we'll hopefully can eat their words, maybe.
Yes, a lot of smiles around Fir Park, and deservedly so. They really played some terrific football today, Motherwell. And one has to say, Derek, that they're at the top of the table on merit.
There's no doubts about it. I think a lot of people said after St Johnstone beat them last week 3-0, the bubbles burst. But certainly they've come back today. And having watched the whole game, I thought Motherwell were magnificent and thoroughly deserved their victory. I mean, at 1-0, there was always a chance that Hearts could come back and sneak an equaliser, but it never happened.
Last year, with some justification perhaps, Motherwell were criticised for playing a defensive game. They did have horrendous injuries, as we know. But now they have a full-strength squad, or virtually full-strength, and they're playing football. Yeah.
Well, they even said that even at the Sixes competition, they played 8 at the back, they were so defensive. But certainly you can't say that about them this year. They've had a go. They've got a side now, a midfield that wants to play football. The young lads that run about, they want to pass the ball. No more of the big punt up the park for them, and it's great to watch. I thoroughly enjoyed watching the game.
What a debut Paul Lambert made. Yeah. Very nearly scored early on with a delightful little chip, didn't he?
Well, he's a class player. He's a young lad that did so much for St Mirren but had to get away. But look at that smashing little chip. I mean, Henry Smith, absolutely no chance with that. But the great thing is he made the run early, and that was an important thing. And
talking about making runs, what about this one from Phil O'Donnell?
This is absolutely incredible run. Watch the injection of pace now as the ball goes by. Look, I mean, that's incredible running at anybody's standards. And that's his so-called bad foot, the right one. I mean, what a smashing ball that was across the box. I mean, they just did it all the time. Although never sat back at any time during the game. Always wanted to go forward. And McGrillan really impressed me. I mean, what great turner of the ball. I mean, Berry's a great marker. But he just couldn't do anything about that. Tremendous run into the box. It's like Brian Robson does for Manchester United. Always gets into that box late to go on the end of it. McGrillan holds on to it, very, very confident, easily to get rid of it there. Just holds on, waits for O'Donnell to make the run. Look at that, he's bad foot again, just side foots the ball into the net. Many people would have blasted it, but not him. Smashing stuff, here he's making runs. I mean, he's some midfield player, the youngster. Once again, wants to hold on to it, a nice wee cross into the box. And in the end, it could have so easily been a goal there. Paul Lambert there, what a hero he'd have been had that ball gone into the net. For me, this is the best buy that Tommy's made. I think Rob McKinnon, what a magnificent player he is. A tremendous left foot on him. It was another little half chance here, but he was playing left midfield today, Rob McKinnon. Instead of full back, he knows he can get up the park. Now, what about that for a run? Now, he was 40 yards away from the player there, Neil Berry, when that ball came back, and he just made the ground up, sprinted there, put pressure on the goalkeeper. And you can see what Berry was trying to do, put it onto Henry's left foot. It didn't work, he didn't hit it hard enough. There, it was just a tap and they won the game with something like 6 minutes to go. Thoroughly deserved, it had to be said in the end.
Yeah, so having paid tribute, rightly we hope, to Motherwell, Hearts played some nice stuff themselves. John Colquhoun looked like the man who carried most threat, really, didn't he?
Well, he did, especially in the first half. I mean, at nothing each, they had a couple of good chances there, and he was very lively, played wide on the right at some time, and then played through the middle. What about this for a turn? You know, marvellous stuff. Great turn here. Krivokovic, no chance. Does everything right. Slips the ball by the keeper, and people are saying, well, what a miss that was. But in the end, a wee bit lucky by the keeper. Look, inside of the heel, because the ball's going in the back of the net.
That's nothing each.
That could make the difference. And for me, this, no doubt in my mind, this is a penalty kick. When you see it from that angle, you're saying, well, it's shoulder. But look, the left hand's over in the wee push. Very, very lucky to get away with that, Motherwell. But in the end, I still thought they thoroughly deserved to win the match.
So can they stay at or near the top of the table, Derek? What would you think?
Well, it's all about a big pool of players. They need that. I mean, on the bench was Davy Cooper and Steve Kirk, and they've still got Ian Angus and Dougie Arnott to come back. Whether that's big enough or not, we'll need to wait and see. I think possibly if they're going to do well, they need a couple of players.
Yeah, but it is nice to see them playing so much good football and getting their award, isn't it?
I think the people of Lanarkshire have got to come out and watch them. That's important. No use playing good stuff like that top of the league and you get 3,000 and 4,000. I think they deserve to get more people watching them.
Absolutely. Some good young players there. So, Motherwell now head the table on their own, a point clear of Dundee United, who are still unbeaten after Andy McLaren's goal saw them home in the Dundee derby. And that despite having captain Dave Bowman sent off in the second half. Charlie Nicholas and substitute Andy Payton both scored twice in Celtic's 4-1 win over Raith Rovers, the Fifers' first home defeat in 18 months. Hibs beat Aberdeen 2-1. Kevin McAllister and Keith Wright were their scorers, while Rangers have now gone four league games without a win after being held.